Morfin, this is it. We are going to make that restaurant.
I always get excited when the opportunity arises to smoke a large chunk of meat. But when I got the opportunity to smoke a whole Iberico leg, I dove into it. Let's start smoking this thing and see how it turns out. A whole leg of an Iberico pig is a lucky find, and I found it online. I'm super excited about it. It comes from thebutchery.nl. Smoking a whole leg is something different than doing a pork butt. You gotta think about it, you gotta prepare. And when you've prepared, you know it's gonna be good. This is one of the most beautiful pieces you can find. A whole Iberico leg is definitely hard to find. And look at it, the hoof is still on. This thing is amazing. And I hope it's going to turn out really, really good. So we're going to keep it a little pure, but at the same time, do our best to make this the best smoked pork leg we've ever made. 24 hours ago, I started the preparation on this leg. The first thing that I did was put a little bit of olive oil on it. The olive oil will help the seasoning stick to the meat. There's a little bit of excess skin on this leg, which I wanna trim off. But once that's done, we're gonna make sure that we loop it all up in that olive oil, and then we apply our seasoning. Starting with a little bit of sea salt, garlic powder, onion powder, paprika powder, a little bit of pepper. And there's no specific recipe to this. You just gotta go all in. Just put a little bit of passion in it. Once you got it all seasoned up, I'm wrapping it in butcher's paper that I already have laying on the table. And then finally, I'm wrapping it in tin foil and placing it in the fridge. There it is. What a chunk of meat. It's an absolute beast. Let's unpack it and take a closer look. Ooh. The smell of this thing, it's absolutely phenomenal. Of course, there's the spices that are penetrating into the meat. The garlic, the onion, the paprika powder. And then combined with the pork, this is going to be so good. It looks amazing already. Let's unwrap it a little further and then put it on the grill. We got the authentic label of the Iberico pork, which means this literally comes from the Iberic region. The only problem that you have with a big chunk of meat like this is finding a grill which it will fit on. And I found one. This is the Bernhardt Flint Pellet Smoker. I loaded up this brand new Bernhardt Pellet Smoker with oak, hickory and apple pellets. We fired up for its initial seasoning, let it cool down again, and now it's ready for our beautiful pork leg. I set the temperature to 120 degrees Celsius, which is around 240 degrees Fahrenheit. Our Flint Bernhardt smoker is ready. We've got a large size cooking surface. Let's hope it fits.
I think it's not gonna fit.
Not gonna fit? You wanna bet? I think it's gonna fit, but I'm not sure. Okay, Morrison, if it fits, then you have to wear another American football t-shirt instead of Alabama Roll Tide. For three episodes. Here we go. Look at that monster. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Look at it. I knew it. I knew it all along. It would fit perfectly. There was never any doubt in my mind. Morrison, you're wearing another t-shirt and I get to pick the team. Well, now we sit and wait. We need at least 4 hours for this thing to pick up enough smoke. When you're cooking a whole pork leg, you're looking for a large grilling surface. Most of the time, gas grills have a large grilling surface, pellet grills have a large grilling surface, so I was looking for a pellet grill that could do the job. Smoking it at a low and slow temperatures, around 120 degrees with a large surface. And this Bernhardt Flint is a perfect smoker for that. Let's take a look. It has a long rack, but it's also very deep. with a lot of surface between the grill grate and the top of the barbecue. We got a thermometer pin here that's keeping a constant check on the temperature inside the barbecue. And we got a big plate deflecting the fat away from the fire, and it's dripping out into the basket. Look at it, it looks like pure gold. The flint is built sturdy out of good quality materials. The controlling system is simplified, so it makes it very easy to control. There's just one knob, you hit that temperature that you're looking for, and it's going to set it to temperature perfectly. I for one can really appreciate this, because when I'm busy, I don't want to be fiddling around with apps and checking for temperatures and alarms going off. I just want my cooker to cook at the temperature that I'm setting it to. All of this for a really attractive price, and that is what I appreciate about a smoker like this. It's simple, it works, it's reliable, and it lasts a long time. A pork leg has the color that I'm looking for. It has a nice smoke accent, which you can recognize by a red mahogany color. So it's time to take it off our pellet smoker and wrap it in aluminum foil. Make sure you use a thick aluminum foil. This will avoid any leakage. Place the pork leg back on the smoker and continue to cook at a temperature of 120 degrees Celsius. Once my Iberico pork leg hit the temperature of 96 degrees Celsius, it was done. We took it off the grill and placed it in a cool box. We're going to let it sit there for at least an hour so it can rest. Resting meat is arguably one of the most important steps that you can do while cooking something to a temperature this high. If you've got a brisket or you got pulled pork, resting it is so important. I can't stress that enough, because during the cooking process, going higher and higher in that temperature range, you're going to let the meat tighten up and squeeze together, and all of the juices are flowing out. But once you let it rest, it's going to be able to soak some of those juices back up, and it's going to make your meat so much juicier. In my experience, resting too long, there's no such thing, as long as it doesn't cool down like below 60 or 50 degrees Celsius, it's still perfectly fine. So just let it sit there, let it do its job. Take your time. And while you're waiting, there's so many great things to do, like make something good to go with our pork leg. We're going to need some ingredients for a tasty pork wrap. We'll start with one red onion sliced thinly, a little bit of fine chopped lettuce, some slices of pickles, and some pickled jalapenos. Of course, we're also gonna need one good looking pancake and a couple of sauces. Now let's take a look at our leg and see if that pork is done. Our pork leg has been resting and it looks amazing. This stuff is ready to be pulled. It is so super tender and so super juicy at this moment. It's just falling apart. The bones are already popping out. We can take them out as easily as that. We've got a beautiful smoke ring. All of the meat is ready to be pulled. This thing is absolutely tender as can be. Of course, we're going to create this beautiful pancake, which we stuffed with all of that goodness that we prepared.
Tasting time.
A bit of that juice. Oh. I've been looking forward to this all day.
This is far more better than I thought it would be. Yeah, come on, the leg, it looks disgusting.
Oh my God, this is, This doesn't need any sauce.
It might be even better than pulled pork.
Wow, I'm gonna say it. This is the best pulled pork I've ever had. Seriously.
Pulled pork has something really thin. It has a more meat structure than pulled pork. It's much more compact.
I could win competitions with this. If you're into barbecue competitions, make sure you get a leg like this. You're gonna win, guaranteed.
Oh, you have to go for the red bits, for the smoky bits.
Oh man.
The smoky bits are the best.
The flavor of the pork in itself without the seasoning, without the smoke, absolutely freaking brilliant. But with the smoke, with the seasoning overnight, it kind of blows my mind. It's absolutely fantastic. I love this. I love this.
Oh, it's a juice. That might be the best part.
I'm gonna apologize right now. I must be eating like a madman, but the weird thing is that it's really a lot of fat, but it isn't heavy. This is insane. All the Dutch people are gonna ask me, where did you get it? Where did you get it? It comes from the butchery.nl.
Seasoning is quite all right, but I think you do need something with it. That's why I think you created this.
I'm gonna take that pancake right now. Morten?
Oh,
this is it. We are going to make that restaurant. We're going to make it happen. This is so good.
What kind of pancake is this? Why is it so yellow?
It's because of the chicken. They lay yellow eggs. This could be our breakfast serving. This is some next level. It's one of these rare occasions that you just have to say it.
Go ahead. It's free. No. It's gone. I'm almost out of pork and you guys keep on pushing me. Yeah, the little one has it. The little one has it. Now the dog monster too.
Nope, it's all mine. You can't have any. This, I'm hogging it. It's mine. Before I'm eating all of this pork leg and turning this into an ASMR video, I'm gonna finish it up. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you did, then leave us a big thumbs up and a comment down below. I had to burp more, so we gotta do it again. A big thank you to all of our patrons and YouTube members. You guys freaking rock, and you know why, because we couldn't do this without you guys. Hope to see you guys next time. Until then, eet smakelijk and
keep on eating pork.
That's right. Cheers, guys. It's freaking good, Marshawn. Seriously. You didn't expect it to be this good.
No.
It was really good.
When I saw that fat, I thought it was horrible.
Yeah. You thought it was going to be overwhelming.
That's not horrible.
But actually, it really isn't. But the fat is different.
Have you tasted juice?
Yeah.
The juice is like the most seasoned part. Like,
yeah.
More salt.
And the outside, the red parts. Like this little bit. It's really nice and brined. So nice and bright, and I like the pancake. It's like the acidity. It's like the perfect marriage.
I can tell you, I like the pancake better than the burrito, I think.
Yeah, but what did you say? No, it's true.
They
get really upset.
How would you feel if they say something about how that cheese is?
You can't talk about the cheese. The cheese is a tongue.